तुलसीदास और गोस्वामी तुलसीदास वॉज अ 16th सेंचुरी ग्रेट हिंदू पोएट एंड सेंट acclaimed as one of the greatest poets in Indian and world literature. He is renowned for his dedication and devotion to the Lord Ram and being the author of great epic the Ramcharitmanas, a devotional retelling of the Sanskrit Ramayana based on Ram's life in the vernacular language Avadhi. The word Ramcharitmanas literally means Lake of the Deeds of Ram. He is also considered to be the composer of the Hanuman Chalisa, a popular devotional hymn dedicated to Hanuman, the divine devotee of Lord Ram. According to legends, Tulsidas was born in 1497 at the banks of the river Ganga in Uttar Pradesh, India. After his birth, instead of crying, he spoke the word Ram. That's why he was named Ram Bola, meaning literally one who utters Ram. Ram Bola's parents abandoned him after birth. The female maid of his mother took care of him, but she also died after 5.5 years. After that event, Ram Bola lived as a poor orphan and walked door to door begging for alms. At the age of 5 years, Ram Bola was adopted by his spiritual guru, Nar Hari Das, an ascetic of Saint Ramanand's monastic order. Ram Bola was given the Diksha, that is, initiation, and was given the new name of Tulsi Das. His guru repeatedly narrated the Ramayana to him, which led him to understand it somewhat. Tulsi Das later came to the sacred city of Varanasi and studied Sanskrit grammar, scriptural readings of Vedas, and the six schools of Hindu philosophy over a period of 15 to 16 years. After study, by the permission of his guru, he started to live in his family home and narrated the story of Ramayana. Tulsidas got married to Ratnavali and they had a son named Tarak who died as a toddler. Once when Tulsidas had gone to a temple, Ratnavali went to her father's home. When Tulsidas came to know this, he swam across the Yamuna river in the night to meet his wife. Ratnavali chided Tulsidas for this and remarked that if Tulsidas was even half as devoted to God as he was to her body of flesh and blood, he would have been redeemed. This awakened Tulsidas from the illusion. He left her instantly and he renounced the household life and became a renunciant. After renunciation, Tulsidas spent most of his time at Varanasi reciting kathas, that is, discourses of Lord Ram to general people. There is a beautiful story of Tulsidas meeting one of the greatest devotees of Lord Ram, Hanuman. As Tulsidas used to recite discourses, he noted that the first listener to arrive at his discourse was an old leper who sat at the end of the gathering. After the katha was over, Tulsidas quietly followed the leper to the woods. In the woods, Tulsidas firmly fell at the leper's feet, shouting, "I know who you are. You cannot escape me." At first, the leper ignored Tulsidas, but Tulsidas did not relent. Then the leper revealed his original form of Hanuman and blessed Tulsidas. Tulsidas expressed his desire to see Lord Ram face to face to Hanuman. Hanuman told him to go to Chitrakoot, a place where he would see Lord Ram with his own eyes. After getting instructed with the Hanuman, he started to live in an ashram in Chitrakoot. One day, when he went for making the pilgrimage to a mountain, he saw the two princes on the horsebacks, but he could not distinguish them. Later, when he acknowledged that they were Lord Ram and his brother Lakshman by the Hanuman, he got disappointed. On the next morning, when he was making sandalwood paste, Ram came to him and asked for a tilak, a religious mark on the forehead, with the sandalwood paste. In this way, he had a full sight of Lord Ram. Tulsidas was so charmed that he forgot about the sandalwood. Then Lord Ram took tilak himself and applied on his forehead and also on Tulsidas' forehead before disappearing. Tulsidas, like all great saints, performed many miracles. In one such, he is believed to have brought back a dead man to life. While the man was being taken for cremation, his widow bowed down to Tulsidas on the way, who addressed her as a woman whose husband is alive. The widow told Tulsidas her husband has just died, so his words could not be true. Tulsidas said that the word has passed his lips and so he would restore the dead man to life. He asked everybody present to close their eyes and utter the name of Lord Ram, on doing which the dead Brahmin was raised back to life. Tulsidas started composing poetry in Sanskrit in Varanasi. Tradition holds that all the verses that he composed during the day would get lost in the night. This happened daily for 8 days. On the 8th night, Lord Shiva is believed to have ordered Tulsidas in a dream to compose poetry in the vernacular instead of Sanskrit. Tulsidas woke up and saw both Lord Shiva and wife Parvati, who blessed him. Lord Shiva ordered Tulsidas to go to Ayodhya and compose poetry in Avadhi, the vernacular language. He also predicted that Tulsidas' poetry would fructify. Tulsidas is also credited with having composed a number of wise sayings and dohas contained lessons for life. A popular one among them is Tulsi Tulsi sab kahe, Tulsi ban ki khas, ho gayi kripa Ram ki, to ban gaye Tulsidas. Meaning, people keep praising me all the time, calling me Tulsi, Tulsi. Tulsi, however, is as insignificant as the grass in the woods. It's only when Ram, the Lord, decided to bestow his grace on me that I became famous and was known as Tulsidas. In the year 1575, Tulsidas started composing the famous Ramcharitramanas in Ayodhya on Tuesday, on the day of birth of Lord Ram. He composed the epic over 2 years, 7 months and 26 days and completed the work on the day which commemorates the wedding of the Lord Ram and his wife Sita. Tulsidas came to Varanasi and recited the Ramcharitramanas at the famous Kashi Vishwanath temple. A popular legend goes that the Brahmins of Varanasi, who were critical of Tulsidas for having rendering the Sanskrit Ramayana in the vernacular language of Avadhi, decided to test the worth of the work. A manuscript of the Ramcharitramanas was kept at the bottom of pile of Sanskrit scriptures in the Sanctum Sanctorum of the Vishwanath temple in the night, and the doors were locked. In the morning, when the doors were opened, the Ramcharitramanas was found at the top of the pile. The words Satyam Shivam Sundaram means literally truth, auspiciousness, beauty were inscribed on the manuscript. Some Brahmins of Varanasi were still not satisfied and sent 2 thieves to steal the manuscript. The thieves tried to break into the ashram of Tulsidas but were confronted by 2 guards with bow and arrows of dark and fair complexion. The thieves had a change of heart and came to Tulsidas in the morning to ask who the 2 guards were, believing that the 2 guards could be none other than Lord Ram and his brother Lakshman. Tulsidas was aggrieved to know that they were guarding his home at night. The thieves were reformed and became devotees of Ram. Tulsidas left his body on the bank of the river Ganges in the year 1623. He lived his life around 126 years. Tulsidas started the Ram Leela plays, a folk theatre adaptation of the Ramayana. The impact of Tulsidas and his work on the art, culture and society in India is widespread. Tulsidas is known in the world as a great Hindu poet and saint. He is known for his immense devotion to Lord Ram and his intense faith in the devotional way to attain salvation. To know more about inspiring stories of saints, you can subscribe to our channel.